The 15th of April 2023 marks the end of the over 60-year-old era of nuclear power in Germany. While the world is still reeling from an energy crisis, Germany decided to take its three remaining nuclear power plants off the grid and get out of nuclear energy for good. So many of you think that the country is making a huge mistake, and you're not alone. Meanwhile, many other powerhouse nations are building new nuclear power plants, even Japan.
Another milestone in the commercialization of China's homegrown nuclear technology.
President Emmanuel Macron announced a plan to build up to 14 new nuclear power plants.
Nuclear power is the only carbon-free energy source we have that can deliver large amounts of power day and night.
And even environmentalists who are traditionally anti-nuclear criticize Germany's exit.
I feel that it's a mistake to close them down in order to focus on coal.
So was Germany wrong to ditch nuclear power? Germans have always had a very special relationship with nuclear power. The first protests were small and local, but the movement spread quickly in the 70s, leading to month-long sit-ins and riots in the following years. And then came the Chernobyl catastrophe. Its radioactive fallout also reached Germany, which further cemented the anti-nuclear sentiment in the public. That led to a unique landmark decision. In 2002, Germany decided to phase out nuclear energy. At that point, 19 reactors were generating over a quarter of Germany's electricity, but they were shut down one by one. And the 2011 nuclear accident in Fukushima sped things up.
In Fukushima haben wir zur Kenntnis nehmen müssen, dass selbst in einem Hochtechnologieland wie Japan die Risiken der Kernenergie nicht sicher beherrscht werden können.
The week of the catastrophe, all older plants were shut down. A few months later, the government decided to get out of nuclear power once and for all by the end of 2022 and focus on renewables to transition out of fossil fuels. Until, well, everything changed.
Russia invaded Ukraine.
Ukrainians fleeing the war, Ukrainian fathers crying as they bid goodbye to their children and partners.
Russia has closed a crucial gas pipeline for Europe.
People are being urged to cut their energy use,
which put Germany in a very tight spot. The threat of a gas shortage loomed. Three of the remaining six nuclear power plants had just been turned off. The country had to resort to firing up old coal plants to make up for it, which pushed up overall emissions. That's when Germany had to start having an uncomfortable conversation again. Polls showed that public opinion had flipped. This one shows three quarters wanted to extend nuclear power until mid-2023, and 41% were even in favor of building new reactors. And so just 1 month before the exit, the federal government, which includes the anti-nuclear Green Party, more or less begrudgingly decided to extend the lifetime of the remaining three power plants by 3.5 months. So the question was, could the war in Ukraine push Germany back into nuclear power? The main problem is that even just extending the lifetime of a nuclear power plant takes months to years of planning. Fuel rods need to be replaced every few years, and that switch needs to be prepared well in advance. The extension was possible because the energy capacity in the remaining rods was stretched. But because of the planned exit, routine inspections had been skipped and workers' contracts terminated. It was already too late to backtrack on nuclear. The German government's position on that is...
We have made a lot of new laws and regulations that support our goal of keeping the energy sector stable.
This is Jan-Niklas Gesenhuis. He's the spokesperson for environmental policy of the co-governing Green Party.
And the only solution to this problem is being much faster and creating a big push for the renewable energies now.
And it's true that since the start of the nuclear phase-out, renewable energy has grown steadily, replacing much of the nuclear power. Right before the phase-out, nuclear accounted for just 6% of the total electricity supply. But focusing only on renewables poses a familiar problem. Have a look at this chart. This is how much renewable electricity was generated on a day in April 2022. First, you have the constant energy coming from hydropower, then biomass, offshore wind, onshore wind, and the big player on this day, solar. In 2022, on average, almost half of the electricity generated in Germany came from renewables. And the government wants to ramp that up to 80% by 2030. But what about the other 20%? And what do we do when the sun doesn't shine and the wind doesn't blow? The amount of electricity needed to compensate for that is called the residual load, and it fluctuates a lot during the day. To fill the gap, we would either need huge batteries to store the energy in peak times, which we are still far from having on a large enough scale, or we need power plants that we can shut on and off very flexibly. Right now, a lot of this flexible adjusting in Germany is done by gas plants, which can be turned on and off completely within just 30 minutes. But they, of course, also emit considerable emissions. To cut those, we need to have a low-carbon energy source. Hydro and biomass are currently not flexible enough for that in Germany. So could nuclear power fill that gap?
Originally, they were conceived to be operated in base load, to provide base load power supply to the power grid.
This is Roberto Ponciroli, chief nuclear scientist at Argonne National Laboratory in the US.
But there are some areas where they are operating load following mode.
That means adjusting the power output flexibly. Some reactors can reduce their output from 100% to 20% in half an hour, twice a day if necessary, like here in this French power plant. France is one of the few countries doing this because of its unique power grid. In 2022, over 60% of their electricity came from nuclear plants, and they adjust their output to the electricity demand. Germany is different. More renewables means more fluctuations, so nuclear plants would have to be a lot more flexible. In France, only about 13% of electricity comes from solar and wind, compared to 50% in Germany.
From a cost-benefit point of view, the best would be to shut down the nuclear power plants when there's a lot of wind and solar.
This is Matthias Mier. He's a researcher looking into the economics of nuclear power.
But this is just not the way it works with nuclear power. Nuclear power is just not suitable to shut down and shut up.
When you do that, it's going to take a lot of hours. And when I say a lot of hours, I mean 30, 40 hours, like a day or two.
And that can cause problems in areas where there is a lot of wind and solar coupled with nuclear energy, like windy northern Germany, where nuclear power plants operated and wind turbines regularly had to be turned off, meaning clean and cheap energy went to waste. So if Germany does install a lot more fluctuating, hard-to-predict renewable energy in the future, using nuclear power instead of gas to flexibly meet the electricity demand could be hard. But the thing is, Germany just isn't there yet. A third of its electricity still comes from dirty coal. And that's where nuclear energy could be useful. To replace coal until renewable energies ramp up enough, batteries are developed enough, and transmission grids are built widely enough to even out the regional differences in wind and solar generation. That's also the line of argument from the nuclear industry.
So when you look at the carbon content of German electricity, it's quite high in comparison to many other countries in Western Europe.
This is Jonathan Cobb, spokesperson for the World Nuclear Association.
The nuclear plants that it did have could have operated for a lot longer, very cost effectively, and provided time where all low carbon sources could have been developed.
Cost is a contentious topic. Critics of nuclear question whether the price of decommissioning plants and storing nuclear waste is calculated appropriately. You can learn more about the cost of nuclear in this video. And there is some discussion on whether keeping nuclear power plants running slows the growth of renewables. But that's hard to pin down since every power system has its own different conditions and constraints. But on the point of emissions, there is agreement. The International Energy Agency sees nuclear power as necessary to lower our emissions as fast as possible. And the IPCC also factors in the growth in nuclear power in most of its 1.5 degree scenarios.
Yes, this is true. I mean, it's a carbon neutral source.
But as we know, in Germany, it's complicated.
This is highly ideological. This is a value. What is my value of the climate thing in a short run? And what is the value of this nuclear accident risk? Plus, what is the value of the risk of radiation, long-term radiation?
The discourse in Germany has centered on the question of safety. The gas crisis did not materialize. A mild winter and an electricity price cap made the winter manageable for Germans. So calls to extend the nuclear power plants became quieter.
So why focus on an old technology that can not guarantee these things, such as nuclear power plants, which are unreliable, which are dangerous? We always also have to think of what is happening with the nuclear waste afterwards, and this comes with very high costs.
Talking about accidents and looking at the numbers alone, though, nuclear is much safer than coal and other fossil fuels. Check out this graph. Not only are fossil fuels way worse for climate change, but air pollution and mining accidents have claimed far more lives than nuclear accidents. Nuclear waste storage is another contentious issue.
There is the solution, which has been agreed widely by the scientific committee, which is burial in deep geological repositories. And the first one is, in fact, going to be coming into operation in Finland.
The site in Finland is the only one in the world in construction. Sweden just licensed a site of its own. But the other 30-plus countries with nuclear power have yet to build or license sites. And the search for suitable areas is long, fraught, and controversial. The fear of contamination has continually sparked protests. One proposed site in northern Germany was abandoned 2 years ago because after decades of research, it was seen as geologically unsafe. And nobody knows how long it's going to take to find another one. And that's the last of many reasons why, despite the swerve during the peak of the energy crisis, Germany probably won't go back to nuclear power anytime soon. New types of reactors, like small modular, fusion or thorium reactors, are not being seriously considered in the country. The government says that the cost and risks of new types of nuclear power are just too high. So was phasing out nuclear the right move? Well, it seemed so when the danger of nuclear power was very present in people's minds. But now that climate change is finally being seen as a crisis, things have changed. International organizations like the IPCC and the IEA think that nuclear power has a role to play in lowering emissions. Large-scale nuclear power is likely not a long-term solution for Germany. When, or rather if, Germany ramped up renewables to 100%, and if energy could be stored efficiently, and if we had a perfect electricity grid, there would be no need for nuclear power in Germany. But that's just not the reality yet. Right now, every ton of emission avoided counts. And that's why Germany may have made a mistake in exiting nuclear faster than other technologies were able to catch up.
So what do you think about Germany's nuclear exit? Please let us know in the comments below and subscribe. We post videos like this every Friday.